Lord, we give you the highest praise.
Lord, we give you the highest praise.
Lord, we give you the highest praise.
Lord, we give you the highest
praise. Sing it again. Lord, we give you the highest
praise.
Lord, we give you the highest
praise.
Lord, we give you the highest
praise.
Lord, we give you the highest praise. Sing blessings,
blessings and honor, glory and power, wisdom, dominion, be thine.
Sing it again, sing.
Glory and power, wisdom, dominion,
sing hallelujah. Come on and sing it with me, say. We love you, Lord, we love you, Lord. Oh, sing it with me. The highest praise.
Lord, we give you 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 the highest
praise.
Lord, we give you the highest
praise.
Say it one more time. Lord, we give you the highest praise.
Lord, we give you the highest praise.
Lord, we give you the highest praise.
Lord, we give you the highest
praise. Lord, we give you the highest praise. Sing blessings,
blessings and honor, glory and power, wisdom, dominion.
Sing it again, sing
blessings and honor.
Good morning, Word of Restoration. One more time for takeover service. Good morning, Word of Restoration. My name is Elizabeth Patton, and I am a fifth grader at the Royal Priesthood Ministries. Hey, it's Takeover Sunday. How's everyone doing? It's going to be an awesome and fun church today. So, let me ask you something. Have you ever been to a friend's house and felt so comfortable it felt like you were already at home? Well, consider this your friend's house, because Jesus calls us friend, and this is his house. So go ahead and get comfortable, because you're amongst friends. And since this is his house, I can not only say welcome, but welcome to Takeover Sunday, and welcome home.
Word of Restoration. Now we will have our podium announcements for Sunday, July 29, and immediately following, we will have our media announcements. If you or a family in the surrounding area are in need of food, toiletries, school supplies, or items to assist the elderly, please contact the office at 281-431-5930. And you can also request an online request form to be placed on the distribution list. Seniors, you may also contact the office at 281-431-5930. And the deadline for your request is Monday, July 30th. DHN Peculiar Parents, get ready for Prayers to Plug, You Prayer Submit. It will be held this Saturday, August 4th, from 9 a.m. to 1 p.m. This will be a life-changing moment you do not want your children to miss. Word of Restoration Drama Ministry will be hosting a two-day training workshop on Friday, August 24th, from 7 p.m. to 9 p.m., and on Saturday, August 25th, from 9 a.m. to 12 p.m. If you are interested in attending these workshops, please register online so that we can prepare. All are welcome, especially men, youth, and teen boys, beginning ages 12 and up. Ladies, it's time for a road trip. Journey to Dallas, Texas, October 18th through the 20th. To the 2018 Women Thou Art Luth Masterclass. Please visit the Word of Restoration website to secure your reservation and get your $50 discount on the conference registration. Availability is limited and seats are going quickly. For any event or activity, please visit the church website at www.woric.org. Please keep the following members in your prayers. Mrs. Wanda Peavy, Mr. Deacon Edgar Peavy, Ms. Joanne Woods, Mrs. Alondra Carmute, and Mr. Clifton Thomas. The following members have experienced a loss in their family. Mr. Everett Lloyd Jackson Sr., the father of Ms. DeAndrea Jackson, passed away and services are pending. Thank you. Now please give your attention to the media announcements. Thank you.
These are your announcements for Restoration News at our Rosharon location. Jesus commanded us to go and make disciples. Join us each week as we continue the summer discipleship training series during our regular Word Wednesday Bible study times at 12 noon or 7:30 p.m. These training sessions are designed to grow you as a disciple of Jesus Christ. Tune in to the local Restoring Lives television broadcast Monday through Friday on theCUBE at 6 a.m. We are restoring lives with the Word of God. Visit Word of Restoration on the World Wide Web at www.woric.org for more information on the many exciting events happening in the City of Restoration. These are your announcements for Restoration News at our Rosharon location. We are restoring lives with the Word of God. And when your life is restored, you shall have double.
Word of Restoration, this is a time in our takeover service that we are not just a special group of people. I mean, you're all special, but there may be some really special people here with us today. We'd like to see you, greet you, and welcome you. So if you're a first-time visitor, please stand at this time. If this is your very first time at Word of Restoration International Church, please stand and remain standing. On behalf of our pastors, Charles Perry Jr., our First Lady, Charlotte Perry, and the entire Word of Restoration family, we welcome you this morning. You could have chosen to go to any church today, but you have missed this takeover service, and you will not have to do that, right? The ushers should have given you a visitor's card. Please complete the first part of the card and place it in the receptacle during offering time. You may keep the other part of the card to remind you of your experience here at Word of Restoration. Again, from all of us directly to you, thank you for being a part of this takeover service. Now let's stand to our feet and welcome one another as well as our first-time visitors.
What's up, Takeover? How y'all doing? All right, at this time, it's time to sow big and get ready to receive big. We got any cheerful givers in the house? All right, that's what I'm talking about. All right, so at this time, if you did not receive an offering envelope as you enter the sanctuary for whatever reason, please raise your hand and our ushers will gladly serve you. And also, while you're preparing to give, we have a special presentation from Peculiar. So please give them your undivided attention.
Good morning, everyone. We're about to demonstrate the process of seed time harvest. This is your God-given seed.
And this is what you do with the seed.
This is the harvest after you plant the seed.
Luke 6:38 says,
"Even it shall be given unto you,
good measure,
pressed down, shaken together, and running over."
All right, that's what's up. So we'll wait 10 minutes if you're still writing that large check, if you still need some time to take them zeros, we got you, we'll wait. No, I'm just playing. It's time for our offering confession, so please get ready for our offering confession. Our visitor was like, will they really wait? No. All right, ready? I am a cheerful giver. Who financially supports the work of God. Jehovah Jireh is my provider. I honor him with my substance, and I give to him from my increase. I return the tithe and give offerings. I live under an open heaven, and God pours out a blessing to me that I do not have room enough to receive. I am a blessing to others. Then God blesses me in return. As I apply the principle of giving, the principle of debt is eliminated from my life and my church. I am a distribution center, dispensing goods to others. El Shaddai is my supply, and I will never lack. He's making me 1,000 times more and blessing me as he promised. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. All right, now, since I'm his favorite, I get to introduce to you What a Restoration. Put your hands together and get ready to receive our man of God, Pastor Charles Perry.
Come on, let's give them a great big hand clap of praise. Glory be to God. Listen, if you were missed, if you would just simply raise your envelope and one of the brothers would gladly come back and receive it from you. And then I see several envelopes raised, brothers. And then to our first time guests, we want to thank you so very much for being here with us this morning. And you were given a visitor's card, asked to complete that card and place it in the receptacle as it passed by if you did not have an opportunity to do that. If you would just go ahead and raise that card and one of the brothers will come back and receive that card from you. It is through that card that we will respond to you in a more personal way for your being here with us this morning. We're so honored and blessed. And we invite you to come back and be with us again. If you do not have an opportunity to give while you're here, there are two offering outlets right behind the guest service counter. You can place your gift there. Someone at the counter will be able to assist you. And then as you give your attention to the screen, you'll see the electronic methods whereby you can give, whether it's the website, whether it's the giving kiosk, whether it's your mobile device through Secure Give, or whether it's just texting to give. Lady Perry and I, we are in agreement with you that every need is met for your personal life. Every need is met for those of you who are entrepreneurs, that you would experience no lack. And every need is met for Water Restoration International Church. If that's where your faith is, let's put our hands together and bless God, because He provides for us, He increases us, and He sustains us. Can we give a great hand clap for our young people this morning? Come on, we can give them a better hand clap than that. They are doing it. Outstanding, superb job. And you know, we have a responsibility. Thank you so much. We have a responsibility to encourage our young people in the things of God. You know, we encourage them in so many other things that they do, and we should, but we have to make sure that when it comes to the house of God and it comes to the things of God, that we encourage them, that we support them, and they know we're there to support them so they can continue on in the things of God. So what a restoration. Thank you for your attendance. We do have some people who are in the overflow. Now, once Minister Tyrone comes up and begins teaching those young people who would like to, you can come down and, you know how y'all do it, sit on the stage and all of that to get the word of God. And that would free up some space also for those who are in the overflow. Those who would like to in the overflow, if you'd like to come and take advantage of the choir stand, you can do that. So if you find out in the overflow, those of you who'd like to sit in the choir stand, you're not going to be asked to sing anything, but you can come sit in the choir stand so you can be in the room. Now, you're not coming in here for the anointing, because I believe wherever you are, the presence of God will most definitely be there. And so you can receive what you need. However, if you're like me, I want to be in the stadium. I want to be where it's at. And so you can come in here, and we will most definitely make room for you. Amen. Now, a couple of things before I move on and do what I'm asked to do. I want to encourage you. Of course, I know many of you were probably not with us this morning for our 7:45 worship experience. You must have that teaching from this morning. You must have the teaching from this morning. That teaching was so powerful. It will most definitely bless your life. It is a teaching, a message that will most definitely set you free. We looked in detail into Jezebel and the life of Jezebel. We looked at her confrontation. We looked at her correction. We looked at her consequences and how she died. And it's a great message in her dying. So just want to encourage you to get it, because you do not have to fear man. Amen. You don't have to be controlled by man, and no man should be controlled by you. And so I want to encourage you to get that teaching, and it will most definitely bless your life. Just a couple of important dates I want to give you, two to be exact. The first date is Sunday, August the 19th. Sunday, August the 19th at 5:00 p.m. We're having a special time of gathering. We just passed the halfway mark for the ministry. We had our vision casting in January. And so I want to come before you on that evening and just let you know where we are. Let you know where we are as a ministry, things that are going on, things that are coming up. We have some very important things that are coming up, and I want to talk to you about that. And also, I'll be talking to you about teen ministry. So I want to make sure all of our teens, I want all of our teens to be here so they can, you know, there's some things I want to do, some things I want to share. I know I heard from the Lord on some things, and so I just want to do that. But we have a host of things that we're going to be discussing and talking about. And you know me, I won't keep you here long. We'll start on time, and I'll get you out in a decent time also. The second date I want you to mark is Sunday, August the 26th. Sunday, August the 26th. That is the last Sunday in the month of August. We will have our Foundation of Faith worship service. Our Foundation of Faith worship service. You got to do better than that. No, you have to do better than that. Glory be to God. Our Foundation worship service, the new facility that we're building, $5 million debt free. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. And so on Friday, they poured the foundation. The foundation of faith has been laid. It has been poured. It is laid and paid. Glory be to God. And so we will have that Sunday, the 26th, we will have one worship experience. We'll be able to get everybody on that foundation. It's very large. We'll have one service early in the morning. Early in the morning. We're not going to be super spiritual out there in all that sun. We're going to come early in the morning. So we're going to come early enough so we can get in and get out. Because I know some of y'all, you know, shout don't go good. You know, sun don't go good with your shout. You know, you're trying to praise. It's hot out here. You're talking about praise the Lord. It's hot out here. So I'm going to try to work with you. Praise God. And so So make sure you mark that date so we can do that. Now, the last thing is I'm going to pray for our young people. They're getting ready to go back to school. It's a couple of weeks away, but want to go ahead and pray while we have them all here together now. Can we do that? How many believe in the power of prayer? Amen. I want every young person to stand, every young person to stand, whether you're going back to whatever level you're returning to, even college. Not only our young people, but everyone who is connected to the school system. You're connected to the school system. Maybe you work for the school. Maybe you're an educator. Maybe you are an administrator. Maybe you are a bus driver. If you are connected, maybe you serve on a board for a school, for your child's school. Everyone who's connected in some kind of way to the school system, I want to pray. I want to pray because we want God's protection. We saw so many unfortunate things that happened last year within the school systems. And so I believe in the power of prayer. And I believe there are some things we have to do in the natural, but we cannot forego prayer. That's power in prayer. So if you would bow your heads with me for a moment. Heavenly Father, I thank you that you are the perfecter of all things. And you perfect all the things that concern us. So all the things that are a concern to us, all the things that matter to us, you will perfect it. Father, you're able to keep what we commit into your trust. And so, Father, we come before you knowing that we have a right to prayer, a right to petition. And you said in your word that you would answer our prayers. Matter of fact, Father, we already know your answer. Your answer is already found in your word. And so this prayer is so we can come into agreement with what you've already stated and what you've already said that you would do. Now, Father, you promise to protect us, and we come into agreement with that protection. Father, you promise to cause us to excel, and we come into agreement with that. Father, you promised us in your word that you would always be with us and you would never leave us, and we come into agreement with that. Father, you promised us that you would make us great and you would make our names great, and we come into agreement with that. Father, you promised that our children would be great in the earth. You said that their composure would be undisturbed. They would have great peace, and we come into agreement with that. Father, according to the book of Daniel, we declare that our children shall be 10 times greater than their peers. We thank you, Father, that our children are protected. You said that no evil would befall them because ministering angels would guard them and would protect them, that they wouldn't even dash their foot against a stone. So, Father, we thank you for the detail of the protection that you make available for our children. And, Father, just recently, all the things that we've seen in the schools with school shootings, Father, we resist it, we reject it, we rebuke it. In the name of Jesus, I cancel every assignment of the devil, every contract of the enemy to bring destruction upon our children, to bring destruction and death into the schools. We reject it in the name of Jesus, and we declare that no weapon that is being formed shall prosper. And so, Father, we thank you for it and we believe it. Father, I even pray your wisdom. I pray your wisdom for teachers, for educators, for administrators, those who serve on boards and on committees of school systems. I pray your wisdom. Father, give them innovation. Give them creativity. Give them answers, for your wisdom flows through man. So give them the wisdom that they need to make the decisions that need to be made, to incorporate the policies that need to be incorporated. And so, Father, we thank you that you will download it. Father, we even pray our children's safety and protection even while they're on school buses, while they're in transit, while they're on their way and on their way from school, to school and from school. We declare ministering angels encamp themselves around those school buses. And we declare those buses free from accidents, free from incident, and free from mechanical failure. Father, I declare that you give our children favor with their peers. And so, Father, you give them favor not only with peers, but also with administrators, and give them favor with those who are in authority, those who are athletics. Father, we pray your best for their life, that they will have awesome seasons. They will have tremendous seasons without injuries, without setbacks. You'll cause them to perform at their maximum capacity and level in the name of Jesus. And I declare, Father, that no child would have to go without this school year, that you shall supply every need. Father, keep their parents employed. Keep their parents with supply. Keep their parents with a source of income and a means of providing in the name of Jesus. So I declare favor for the parents, that you're opening up gainful employment, that no child would have to go without, that no child would have to come out of school, would have to leave college because of a lack of provision. I call in, Father, scholarships in the name of Jesus. I declare education paid in full in the name of Jesus. And Father, I thank you. Those who are academic, I thank you, Father, you'll cause them to excel. You'll cause them to stand out. You'll cause them to be noticed and recognized. So, Father, we declare uncommon favor on our children. That is something about ours that will stand out, because your promises is to the seed of the righteous. And because we've been made righteous because of Jesus Christ, and our children are our seed, so we receive every promise that you've made available to them. It's in the name of Jesus we pray. Amen. Come on, let's give the Lord a great big hand clap of praise. The dancers are going to come. They're going to minister to us, Restoration in Motion, also Hopeful Mime Dance Ministry. They're going to come. They're going to minister to us. And then following that, Minister Tyrone Smith, he will be introduced via video. But before that, I just want to publicly just thank him for being here with us today. I want to thank his family for joining him. He is an awesome man of God. He's an awesome man of God. He has a heart for youth, a heart for young people. Been doing it for many, many years. He is the director, the youth director at Church Without Walls, Dr. Ralph Douglas West. And so, amen, praise God. And he's been youth director there for over 15 years. He's been the youth director there at Church Without Walls, doing a phenomenal job. I had an opportunity, always heard about him, had an opportunity to really sit and listen to him not long ago at an event. And I tell you, when people speak, when you hear people speak, you can tell when someone has an authentic relationship with God. And so I was very impacted. My wife and I both, with just his ministry and just his heart for young people. And so what a restoration. We are honored to have him with us today. We're going to be blessed by the ministry of the word that he's going to share. And so we just thank him for his genuineness, his authenticity. We thank him for his revelation and his message that he's going to bring here this morning. So thank you so much, Tyrone, for being here with us today. Can we give him a hand before he comes up? Thank you so much. So the dancers are going to come, the video is going to roll, and the next voice you will hear from this podium will be that of Minister Tyrone Smith.
And at that time, Jesus came from Nazareth in Galilee and was baptized by John in the Jordan. And as Jesus was coming up out of the water, he saw heaven being torn open. Do you hear that? When he came up out of the water, he saw heaven being torn open. When you come up out of whatever you've been down into, you need to see heaven being torn open. And the Spirit descended upon him like a dove. Are you hearing what I'm saying? Touch your neighbor and say, he's getting ready to tear heaven open for you.
Hallelujah.
The glory of the Lord is rising in this place. Can't you feel His presence, His power and His grace? Open up the heavens as we call upon Your name. Release our destiny, will never be the same.
Can you feel His presence, power and His grace? Open up the heavens as we call upon Your holy name, saving name of Jesus, healing name of Jesus, righteous name of Jesus, healing name of Jesus, wonderful name of Jesus, mighty name of Jesus, strong name of Jesus.
Tyrone Smith is a nationally recognized motivational speaker, author, and retired NFL player with a passion for empowering youth and young adults. He believes that every life has a purpose, and everyone has the opportunity to do a greater good in the lives of others. It is from this belief that a desire was born in Tyrone Smith to make a difference in the lives of today's youth.
What is it that you can do better in your family? What is it you can do better for your wife, for your household? What can you do better for your kids? And I realized this. I cannot expect anybody to influence my son like I can. So I said, there's an opportunity that I must take full advantage of. And I ask you this, are you using your influence the right way to do and be all that God has called you to be in your own family?
Word of restoration. Let's welcome Mr. Tyrone Smith. It's the Takeover.
Man, Pastor Perry, man, brother, thank you, man, for the opportunity to come and share, to be a light to your ministry. First Lady, I appreciate the opportunity for you guys just giving me a moment in time like this to humble myself before the congregation. Pastor Perry, it's football season, man. I get excited. So I may tackle somebody. So people in the choir stand, if I just come and tackle you, brother, don't take it personal, all right? You know what I'm saying? It's about that time. You know what I mean? Everybody's in training camp, and this training camp is going on, man, and I get an itch. But I'm truly grateful and thankful to be able to come and share with you all today. And once again, Pastor Perry, man, many blessings to you and the First Lady. Can you give the First Lady and Pastor Perry a hand come of praise, man? Awesome ministry. Doing a great work. And I really appreciate having my family here with me as well. I have my mother-in-law, Patricia Leakes, my two sons, Tyrone Smith II, and Tyler, and I have my wife. She's like the bomb.com. Now, check this out. We've been married for like 21 years, 1 month, 1 day, and 18 hours and 24 seconds. I thank God for the Monica Smith being my wife. But I'm truly grateful and thankful to come and share with you all this morning, because youth, it's about a takeover. It's about understanding and knowing that God has put you in the position to do capable and amazing things. But it's about you understanding, knowing, and believing, and holding true for who He has actually designed you for. So when you think about a takeover is really about assuming control. Assuming control. When I think about a takeover, the first takeover that actually comes to my mind, I think about LeBron James. LeBron James was predicted to actually take over the NBA when he was in high school. LeBron James was a three-time what? National Basketball League champ. A three-time NBA Finals MVP. A four-time league MVP. 14 appearances in the All-Star Game, hardly, and two gold medals. He actually took over the NBA in 2003 as the first pick in the NBA draft. But youth, what I want you all to understand is that God designed each and every one of you youth to be kings and queens to take over this world for Jesus Christ. And the challenge is understanding, knowing, believing, and holding true who God has called and created each of you all to be. My message today is designed to challenge the young people to realize and know the capacity of your faith and your growth in Christ, to challenge your peers at school this upcoming year to be who God has called and created you to be, because there will be a takeover. But you must be prepared, you must be ready for the takeover. And it reads in 1 Timothy 4, it says, do not let anyone look down on you because you are young, but set an example for believers in speech, in conduct, in love, in faith, and in purity. Paul is actually challenging Timothy. But I want you all to realize, understand, though, there are multiple examples in the Bible where God used young people. Yes, Joseph was sold into slavery by his brothers. At the age of 17, he was positioned to actually take over the land. He was positioned to actually save Israel from a famine. He actually moved from the pit to the palace. God would use young people. God used a young man to actually overcome the Philistines. He used Jesse's youngest son, David, the one who actually hung out with the sheep to kill, to destroy the giant. God used young people. God used a young lady by the name of Mary to birth our Savior into this world, to be and come to die on the cross for our sins and our transgressions. God will use young people. But today, students and young people, I want you to understand your position. God has called you to be great. And I come from a household where my mom and my dad got divorced. I come from a household where my mom didn't finish middle school. My dad didn't finish high school. I'm the youngest of three boys. And my mom told me, she was like, Tyrone, I believe that you're special. I believe that you would do amazing things with your life. God has designed you to be great. But it was hard for me to believe that I could be instrumental in being great in regards to who God had actually called, designed me to be. Because growing up as a kid, people would always pick on me. They would tell me, Tyrone, you're not going to do anything with your life. You're too small. You're too skinny. You got a big head. You cry all the time. Why y'all laughing? They said, dude, you're not going to do anything. I was like, but I want to go to the NFL. They're like, dude, how are you going to go to the NFL? You're too small, you're too skinny, you got a big head, you crawl time, you're not good enough, you're not big enough, you're not fast enough, you're not cute enough. I'm like, what does cute have to do with it? You wear a helmet. But God designed me to be great. And although people looked at me as being otherwise, although people looked at me as being less, God positioned me as a young man to do amazing things. So youth, I want you to realize, recognize, and understand that God has positioned you to do great, but I need you to realize your greatness. So give our youth a hand clap this morning, everybody. Let me give you a little background on Paul and Timothy. So here it is. So Paul is Timothy's mentor. He's his spiritual leader. Now you have a spiritual leader at Pastor Perry. He empowers, he equips, he encourages, he guides, he leads, he loves, he directs you. So all those things that Pastor Perry do for you all as a ministry congregation, Paul did the same thing for Timothy. And Paul is letting Timothy know, check this out, man. You're going to take over the church, but I want you to understand, though, that there are people in the church, in the ministry, in the community, don't believe you can actually handle the job. But although you are young, God has designed you for this moment and for this time. Trust me, just understand and know to believe and believe that God has positioned you for this moment. I don't need you to grow weary. I need you to be true. I need you to be real, to the call because you have a stable and solid foundation in Christ. You are the man for the job. I need you to understand that, Timothy. So Paul's letting him know, man, I want you to be on point because I trust and believe and know that you will be on point. Paul trusts and he believes. But there are people in the community, there are people in the church that don't feel and believe he's the man for the job because he's young. You can be young and you can do great things. But the biggest thing that you must do as young people, we must realize, understand, know, and remain accountable to the Word of God. And if you remain accountable to the Word of God, you're putting yourself in the position when people look at you otherwise, you know that you are the man or that you are the young lady for the position because God has positioned you otherwise because he has designed you to be great. Understand this. I'm going to pause for a moment. In regards to what you experience, deal with, or go through as individuals, God has designed us as believers for a time as this. Everything that we saw in the service and pre-service and experience, God has designed for those non-believers to come and be a part because they need to see this. And the challenge is, will you recognize your position in the call to be who God has called you to be, to bring those, to go and make disciples, to be a blessing to others, to come and see, understand, so they can know and grow and be who God has called them to be? But to do that, you have to be unashamed. And to be unashamed, you have to be true to who God has called you personally to be. A lot of people miss in leadership what it means to be who God has called them to be because they don't want to lead by example. But Paul charges Timothy with 5 specific examples. He said, do not let them despise you. Do not let them look at you otherwise in regards to who you are based on your age. But there are 5 fundamental things I need you to do to actually recognize your position. And what he said was this right here. He said, be an example in speech, the power of your communication. I believe that Paul is challenging Timothy to watch his speech because there's power in speech. There's power in your words. Words can be inspiring. Words can be harmful. I remember back in 1985, Pastor Perry, I first started playing football for the very first time. I played for the Windsor Redskins over in Missouri City, and I played for the Windsor Redskins. And when I played for the Windsor Redskins, I was really excited about the game of football because the game of football was my outlet. When I played for the Windsor Redskins, that year we only went like 1-9. We won 1 football game. And we only won that 1 football game because the other team didn't show up. But hey, baby, a win is a win. Hey, you know, we throwing confetti. You know what I mean? We making the rain because we won the game because the other team didn't show up. Like, woo, we won the game because the other team didn't show up. But I was fascinated, Pastor Perry, by the game of football. And so I'm fascinated by the game of football. And my oldest brother, he actually had a friend who was a local community high school football star that eventually went to the NFL and went on to do some major things in life. My brother knew him because he played on the other side of town for one of the other local high schools. And my brother told this young man, he's like, man, my youngest brother, Tyrone, he loves football. He would appreciate it if you come and just holler at him and say hello or maybe sign an autograph. And so my brother told me, he's like, Tyrone, the guy's gonna come by on Saturday morning at 10 o'clock. So I'm excited. 9:30 roll around, I'm looking out the window. You know, I got my little afro picked out. You know, I got my shorts on, you know what I mean? I had like a little red tint with a little S-curl from the sun. And then I, you know, got a little red and all that and everything. So I'm waiting, I'm looking out the window. He isn't coming. So 10:15, roll around, look out the window. I'm like, Harold Jr., where is he at? He was like, dude, just relax. Calm down. He's coming. So 11:30, roll around, Pastor Perry. I'm looking out the window. The guy isn't there. And I'm like, man, when is he coming? Like, Tyrone, relax. The guy is going to come. Because in my mind, what I'm realizing, I'm like, what is this individual going to say to me that's going to be with me for a lifetime? What words, what power in his voice, what power in his speech will he say that would impact my life in regards to me searching and seeking and needing help and support based on what I was dealing with and going through as a young person? What is he going to say? 12 o'clock roll around. I look through the window. Nobody. 2 o'clock. I'm mad at my brother. I'm like, where's the dude? He was like, I don't know. So the guy didn't show up. And at that moment, I realized I'm seeking and searching, wondering what he would have actually said to me that would be with me for a lifetime, and he missed the mark. And this is what I said to myself. If I'm ever put in the position to be a light, to be influenced in regards to speaking life, speaking hope, speaking power, speaking love in the life of individuals or young people. I'm going to always show up and I'm going to be on time. There's power in your speech. Young people, you have to be the example in your speech. When you go to schools, you have friends and classmates who are actually looking at you because they know you go to Word of Restoration. And they're looking and they're listening and want to see what are you going to say based on your speech. You have the capacity of influence. You have the capacity to speak life, but be intentional about speaking life in those young people and those friends that you serve and that you support based on what they deal with and go through on a daily basis because they're looking for direction. You have the capacity to give direction. You have the capacity to speak life. So I challenge and charge you, be the example in your speech, in your conduct. Paul tells Timothy, be the example in your conduct. How do you carry yourself? Because I can assure you there are people watching and looking on a daily basis. My second year in the NFL, my wife and I had the opportunity to go on a cruise. It was a celebrity cruise with pro athletes and commentators from the NFL Network and ESPN. And Pastor Perry, we're on this cruise, and I was the youngest NFL player on the cruise. You know, I'm like, you know, second year in. And they had all these guys who were in the Hall of Fame, guys who played like in the 60s and 70s. And so it was an opportunity for me to just, you know, just let my light shine and be an example. But there's this one particular commentator for ESPN at the time. His name was Mike Godfrey. Oh, so my wife and I, Monica, were standing in the line, and Mike Godfrey, Big Rob, he's looking at us. He's looking. He was like, just looking. You know, a white guy. He just keeps looking at me. I'm using my deductive reasoning. I'm from Third Ward. I'm like, man, why is he looking at me like that? And so Monica and I, you know, I'm like, Monica, you see that man looking at us? And he's just looking. And he comes over to me. He said, Tyrone Smith, man, it's a blessing and an honor to actually meet you. He said, I'm sitting on the other side. I'm not trying to look at you so hard, but there's just something that's just different about you. He said, I've been kind of checking you out here the whole time, you and your wife, and I'm checking out how you've been conducting and actually carrying yourself, your behavior, what you say and what you do, and how you've been connecting with the fans and really being a blessing to others and being unashamed about sharing your faith. But I've been actually checking you. I've been checking you out, dude. He said, I just want to come and just thank you, man, for just honoring the Lord with your gifts. So this man, we've been on this cruise for multiple days. He told me, say, since we've been on the cruise, I've been seeing how are you going to conduct yourself as a person? How are you going to conduct yourself as a believer? Because I heard you tell somebody that you was a believer, but I'm like, are you going to live it? Yeah. Understand this, students, your peers, your friends, they're watching and looking and seeing how are you going to conduct yourself? Yes, and understand this. Take that as a challenge and a charge to know that you can use your influence to make an impact. And Pastor Perry, it don't mean anything if they don't take everything they receive from the takeover service and your message and everything else and applying it to the community. Because there are people who are in need. There are people who are lost. And you have the capacity to impact the world only if you're intentional about how you carry yourself and your behavior and your conduct. Paul says, be an example in your conduct. Paul says, be an example in love. Loving your neighbors as you love yourself. We love because he first loved us. 1 John 4:19. So when you think about love, for God so loved the world, he gave his one and only begotten son down the cross for our sins, our shortcomings, and our transgressions. So I understand, I believe, I know I'm accountable to it. But when you love, do you truly love your neighbor as you love yourself? Are you unashamed? Do you really like love somebody when somebody wrong you? Tell the truth. No answers. The reality is, if we love the way that Christ loved, the world would be so much greater. The world would be so much better. But it's going to take you to be intentional about loving your neighbors as you love yourself. And I ask students all the time. I say, when you think about the capacity of love, if you go to school, and you love the way that Christ has designed and called you to love, your campus will be so much greater and better. Because here we go right here. I did this with our youth at our church about a year ago. I asked them, I said, when you go to school, do you utilize school or see school as a prison or a platform? If you had a love of Christ, you can use school as a platform. If you see school as a prison, that means you go to school day to day in your mundane routine, you just go to class, just pass time with your routine. Because why? That's how you do it in prison. It's a standard routine. There's not too much change, not too much difference in the routine. I said, but if you use school as a platform to make Jesus Christ famous, yes, you can make your campus different. Yes, sir. Be the example in love. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. So this is what I told our youth. I said, this is what I want you to do. I said, I want y'all to pray and think about one person or one friend you know that needs prayer. And I'm gonna ask you all to do the same. I want y'all to think for a moment. This is what I did with the youth. Think about one person you know that's struggling, battling, dealing with something that needs prayer. Raise your hand. If you know somebody that just needs prayer, just raise your hand. Okay, it's pretty much everybody. So I did the same thing with our youth. I say, now, next, when you see that person, one day, 2 days, 3 days from now, I want you to go to them. One or two things are going to happen. I want you to go to them and let them know that you prayed for them. I said, one or two things are going to happen because why? You're showing love. You've been an example by giving them love. Number one, they're going to say, thank you for praying for me. The second thing they may say is like, number two, like, you know, why did you actually pray for me? And if they ask you, why did you pray for me? It's going to open up the door to share your faith. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. That's love. Yes, sir. And when they open up the door, you got to go through the door. You got to be the example, be the king, be the queen that each of you guys are. Be an example in love. There was one kid by the name of Marcus. He went and told this young lady he was praying for, because this young lady, she was dealing with stuff and she was going through stuff. And she was like, dude, you don't even look like you pray for people. There was an opportunity for him to share his faith. There was another opportunity with a young lady. She went to this young man that she told that she had been praying for. And he said, you know what? My mom and dad had got divorced. I was thinking about suicide. I needed to know that somebody was praying for me. Somebody was in my corner. That's love. Be the example in love. And the thing that you have to realize as individuals, there are going to be opportunities where you can take over circumstances and situations if you live your life in such a way that you're intentional. If you're not intentional about living for God, things won't happen. And as a church and as a community, we have to know our place and our position. God has positioned you and designed you to take over. But the thing is, you have to be willing to take over. You can't get all you can, while you can, and put it in the can, sell in the can, just leave it here at the church. You got to go beyond the church to actually impact the community and campuses through love. And if you understand and know that, the church will grow to a whole nother level. Yeah. Yes, sir. But you have to be intentional. So I challenge and charge you, as Paul challenged Timothy, be the example in love. And then next, don't let them despise you because you're young, but be the example in faith. Faith means to believe in something. We believe in God. We put our faith in God. My faith is in God, not in people or circumstances. And when I think about the capacity of faith by being an example in faith, if you say you believe, do you believe all the time and all that you deal with and go through? Because in life, you either what? Going through a storm, about to go, going through a storm, in a storm, or just finish a storm. And your faith is what you will stand on in regards to truly being an example when you go through stuff. Understand this. Thursday, I'm talking to my father. It was about a month and 3 days ago, my father had an accident in East Texas, go to East Texas, go get my dad. My dad, take my dad to the hospital, be an example in faith in East Texas, in Jasper, Texas. He has a broken L1, he has an enlarged prostate, his kidney numbers are up, he has urinary tract infection. So I just came from speaking out of town, Pastor Perry, on the 26th of June, drop Monica and the kids off, 30 minutes later, go to Jasper, Texas, take my dad to the emergency room at 8 o'clock. 1 o'clock, we got to go to Bowman because he needs to see a specialist, broken L1, prostate, kidney, urinary tract infection. So I'm in Bowman unexpectedly for five days. Our anniversary was like on that Thursday, where I'm actually like in Bowman. I actually come back, and they tell me I got to actually admit my dad into a nursing home. So I had to move him from Jasper to a skilled nursing home in Katy. So we're in Katy. He's staying in Katy. He's been independent all this time. He's frustrated. He's mad. But I'm being faithful, and I'm trusting and praying unto God. Man, let me help me empower this man to know it's about me loving on him and knowing that he needs this right now. I got to be faithful to my dad. So I'm faithful to my dad. He's in the nursing home. While he's there in the nursing home, Pastor Perry, he's been there for about a month now. On Thursday, he's been trying to get up and do his own thing. I'm like, Dad, you got to relax. You can't move right now. You need strength. You need help. You need support. He was like, man, I can move around. So talk to him on Thursday. He falls. On Thursday night, they rush him to the emergency room. They go to the emergency room. He had a hip replacement surgery on Thursday. I'm out of town speaking. Had to come back. Make sure Dad was squared away. Go out of town to speak on Friday. Speaking on Friday, they called me and tell me mama's in the same nursing home, but she's actually on the other end. She had a fall. They had to rush us to the hospital as well. But I'm actually faithfully focused in knowing that God is in control. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. I'm out of town speaking, come home, get home, knowing I have a commitment to come here today for this takeover service. Because why? This is what my faith is about, doing what God has called me to be, to tell the story and the journey. My hope and trust is in nothing less but Jesus Christ and his righteousness. And I understand and I know and I trust and believe when you're in those hard times, will you be faithful to the cause? Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Will you be open? Will you be honest? Will you be genuine? Will you be real to know that God is faithful? In 1987, when I was an eighth grader at Crystal McCullough Middle School, I'm talking about my mom and my dad. My mom and my dad got divorced. In 1987, I'm in middle school and I'm wondering, low self-esteem, no hope, no confidence. God, how can I be used to do anything in this world? People are talking about me, people are bullying me, but I had to get to a point and realize that I had to be an example in my faith because I believe, and I went to a Bible study and I connected with a scripture that states, Proverbs 3:5-6, trust in the Lord with all your heart and all your ways, acknowledge him, for he will lead your way and direct your path. That's faith. At the end of the day, when you battle, when you struggle, when you deal, when you go through things, be the example in faith.
Yes, sir.
So young people, you got to be the example to understand and know that God has put you in the position, regardless of what you deal with and go through, to practice your faith, to put your faith in action. So when you think about the takeover, it's about how can you position yourself to put your faith in action. And if you're not putting your faith in action, you are missing the mark based on what and who God has called you to do as individuals. Will you be the example through faith? Because we're called. You're not guaranteed to see me again, but I understand and know I have a platform and I have an opportunity to share. And I challenge you to be the example in faith. One last point. Be the example in purity. What does purity mean? Purity means preserving yourself and not letting the things of the world taint you. Preserving yourself for the things of Christ. Purity means to have moral character. Purity means the rights and the wrongs of life. Be an example in purity. There was a young man by the name of Aaron. He's 16 years old that I actually met on yesterday. And I asked him, why are you so unashamed about Christ? He said, what I realized, Mr. Smith, is that 3 years ago, my pastor asked me to come and pray at the church. And he said, when he asked me to come and pray at the church, I had nothing to give. He said, and I truly felt and realized I had nothing to give because of what I was looking at and what I was listening to. He said, my heart was not righteous because it was tainted with all the music and all the shows and the type of people I was actually hanging around. He said, I was convicted in that moment, in that time. And all my pastor did was just ask me one question. And I had nothing. But I realized I needed to have a pure heart in regards to being who God actually called me to be. So I had to realize, no, I had to actually replace those dead things with things of life and with things of hope to understand and know that I had only so many moments in time, so many moments in time here on earth to be who God has called me to be. So to be pure, to be righteous, I had to separate myself. Be the example in purity. And he realized that as a young man, because he said, I have a platform to let my peers, I have a platform to let adults know. And this is what he told me yesterday. He said, I am unashamed about challenging and charging both youth and adults to be who God has called them to be. I was like, wow, the takeover. But you got to realize that Jesus Christ approved this message. And if this message is approved, because why? It's scripture-based. If it's approved, it's about will you follow through and make this message be a part of your life based on what you do as individuals. It don't mean anything if you're not willing to be who God has called you to be.
Yes, sir.
Because one thing that God gives us, he gives us free will. And free will is the ability to make our own choice and decisions as individuals. What decision will you make? I have a question for you before I close. It says, do not let anyone look down on you. Do not let anyone despise you. It don't mean anything if you haven't said yes to Christ. You can hear this, but it won't mean nothing to you because why? You haven't said yes. And if you're in a point or situation, a place in your life right now, and you haven't said yes to Christ, today would be a good opportunity to do so. So as I prepare to close, Jesus Christ gives us free will. And free will is the ability to make our own choices and decisions as individuals. And if you understand the capacity of free will, you have an opportunity today on July 29th here at this takeover service to do life and to do life differently. But your life will only be different if you say yes and your yes means something. So today if you're here and you feel led to make a decision for Christ, this could be an opportunity for you to say yes, and your yes means something. You've been missing it, and your way hasn't been working. You've been disconnected from the world. You've been disconnected from the church, and you missed the mark. But what you need to do is realize, understand, know that God has approved you to do so much greater and better than where you are. But what you need to do is actually make a decision. And I thank God for the decision. But it's not about my decision because I've made a decision. It's about you. And if you make a decision for Christ, I can assure you that you will never lose. It's about you being open. It's about you being honest. And it's about you being real. Just think for a moment. Think about where you are. Think about the struggles. Think about the issues. Just know this could be your moment and your time to do life and to do life differently. The doors of the church are now open and extended before you if you feel led to make a decision. It's about you right now. If you're here today, you feel as though you need to reconnect with Christ. You need to reset the button. You need to start over. It's not a bad thing to start over. Just hit the reset button. If you're here today and you feel led to rededicate or recommit your life to Christ, this is a good day to do so. Because outside of Christ, it's hard to live. Outside of Christ, it's hard to function. Outside of Christ, it's hard to survive. And just know that your life is that valuable. But you need to be the one to make a decision. And once you make that decision, everything in your life will change. A new mindset, a new outlook, a new perspective to truly be who God has called you to be. Is there anyone? It's about you right now. I know we have a few visitors. Maybe you're visiting for the very first time. You're looking for a church home where you can be equipped and encouraged to be who God has called you to be. Word of Restoration, where Pastor Perry will support you, will love on you, will encourage you, will guide you, will support you to be that man, that woman, that child of God that God has called you to be. So if you feel led to make a decision, a move either to give your life to Christ, to rededicate your life to Christ, a church membership, today is a good day. Amen. Amen. Let's celebrate. We celebrate. It's not too late. God bless you, sister. It's not too late. We're here waiting on you. If you're here, this could be your moment. This could be your time. But you have to be intentional about making decisions to know that you can live and you can live victorious. It's about you right now. We're waiting on you. In life, it's about moments. And this can be your moment for you to do life and do life differently. For you to do life and to be bold. For you to do life and to be unashamed. For you to do life to know that you're victorious. For you to do life to know that you will win. Is there anybody else? This today is a good day for you to start over by trusting, understanding, knowing, and believing that He is real. But you will not understand this realness until you say yes. And your yes means something. Because we say yes to a lot of things in life that we don't care for. But if you say yes today, you will never lose. And you proclaim the victory in His name. It's about you today. Can we celebrate our brothers and sisters, everybody? Can we celebrate them? 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 Brother, I want to thank you, man, for your faithfulness, man, for leading your family. We need more men leading a family like you, man, to be the example. To be the example. You're young, man. We're all young. So we can all be the example. So I appreciate you, man. God bless you, man. I thank you, man, for your faithfulness. Sister, I thank you for your boldness and being unashamed to make a decision to know that you can truly be used by God. But you can only be used by God because now you've made a decision. He looks on you and He smiles, sister. Thank you, young man, for making the decision to come and recognize and know. And sister, we appreciate you, man, for being unashamed and being bold. Despite the fact you're in an environment with a lot of people, you know that there's a need in your heart for better. And God smiles at you right now. He honors you right now. He honors you for your decision. He honors you for your faithfulness. He honors you, sister, for being bold. Despite what others may think, it's about Him being in your heart. And I thank you, Mom, for bringing you and your kids. Because understand this, in order for them to be who God has called them to be, they're going to follow you. And you brought them here. And there's so much more, sister, He's going to do with you in your life. Despite the fact things have came and gone, it's about you and who you are and whose you are. To God be the glory, everybody. To God be the glory. We celebrate, we trust, we know, and we believe. We celebrate our brothers and sisters. Amen. Amen. If you can you please follow our sister over here? Can everybody please? Hey, big guy, pause in the game. Just hold on 1 second. You getting it, man. Hold on. Follow him right here. Thank you for your faithfulness, everybody. Can we celebrate our brothers and sisters for just being who God has called them to be? Thank you, man. God bless you, brother. Amen.
Thank you.
Thank you, man. God bless you, man.
Yes, sir.
Thank you.
Bless you.
Come on, let's put our hands together.
Thank you, man.
Let's thank God for the harvest first. Come on, can we celebrate the harvest? Come on, heaven is rejoicing. The Bible says it just takes one for heaven to rejoice. Can we give a sound of what heaven may sound like right now? Just for the ones who have come. Lives changed forever. Glory be to God. And can we put our hands together for the awesome ministry of Tyrone Smith, Minister Tyrone Smith. What a powerful, powerful, powerful word. Awesome message of faith. And even though he was talking to, go ahead and stand and we're going to release you and speak the blessing in just a moment. Not only was he talking to the young people, to our students of being that example, being an example in their speech, being an example in conduct, being an example in faith, being an example of purity, being an example of love. But how many know that's relevant for us also? We can all be an example. You can be an example at the job. You can be an example in your family, in your community. You can be an example in the neighborhood. We can be an example right here in the house of God. And so again, let's put our hands together and thank God for that awesome message, awesome word. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you so, so very much. Listen, our young people have done an awesome, awesome job today. Awesome job today. And I want to thank, because it's a collaboration of all of our youth ministries coming together. Royal Priesthood, Children's Ministry, under the direction and leadership of Dana Thomas and her leadership team. Can we thank God for them? Thank God for them. Thank you so much, Dana, wherever you are. Thank you so much with your leadership team. And then our Peculiar Middle School Ministry under the leadership of Michael Jackson and the leadership team there. Can we celebrate Michael Jackson and the Peculiar leadership team? And then, of course, GHN, Generation Holy Nation, our high school ministry. Elder Sean William is the elder there. And Caleb Perry is acting leader at this moment with them. So can we put together our hands together for them and the leadership team? And the leadership team. And the dancers, Elder Smith, also with Terrell Williams, who are responsible for the dancers, and DeAndre Jackson. Can we thank the dancers, all the dancers for their part? The choir, Andre Vincent, along with the band and the choir and the praise team. Man, those young people, did you see them, those praise singers? Worshiping God. They wasn't just singing. They wasn't just standing up there just singing. I mean, they were involved. They were involved. They were engaged. And so I thank God for what's happening. I thank God for what's happening. And Minister Tyrone is so right. It's time to take over. It's the takeover. And not just when you see these services we do, the takeover, it's not just the young people taking over the service. But it's the young people, when they leave here, allowing God to take over their lives so they can take over territory for the kingdom of God and not let the devil run things and control things. Amen? Can you say amen to that? Again, I want you to, as we depart, I want you to get the CD from this morning. I also spoke to some things that's happening in the political realm, things that we say in connection to the Jezebel spirit and the fear of man that we even see in politics. And so I want you to get it and let it be a blessing to you so you can always be aware. People of God, we can pray, but we need to know what we're praying for and what we're praying against. You got to know what you're addressing before we can change anything. So thank you. Thank you, Water Restoration, for coming up, coming out. I know some of you normally come to that early service. By this time, you done been to lunch. You back home getting your Sunday nap. And so thank you for hanging out with us for the late service. We appreciate that. And everything was just awesome. Amen. So thank you so very much. Raise your hand so we can receive the blessing of the Lord. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord cause his face to shine upon you. The Lord be gracious unto you. The Lord show you his kindness. The Lord give you his peace, and he surrounds you with his favor. Go in the blessing of the Lord. We love each of you, and we'll see you on Wednesday for discipleship training, either at 12 noon or 7:30.